suffer from paralysis, that the medicine may differ for people with... Hold it in your mouth, not with the spoon. It just, I had described one of my patients, ki hold two spoons of mouth oil in your mouth, the head hold it with the spoon inside. You can keep the spoon aside. Yeah, you can the toxins are removed. And the extra cough secretions, people who are getting extra sputum or extra cough secretions, it is all absorbed and thrown out of the body. So this is a part of, this is one part of oil. So whatever openings we have, we... Yeah, good for all the diseases above neck. It could be thyroid, it could be tonsillitis, it could be eye problem, it could be hair problem. All the problems it is going to help. Apart from that, it is going to help to constrict the vessels. So varicose veins, where the vessels are expanded, it can help. This, if you keep on questioning why, it could be a long research process, but if you do it, you can see the results. So you have to decide whether you keep questioning it or whether you follow it as a tradition. So this is the one opening. Like I talked about anus, medication, basti through anus, karnapuran, then comes nasya through nose, gandush in the mouth, netra tarpan for your eyes. We use the medicated ghee and hold it in, you keep on opening and closing your eyes, unmesh and nimesh, which we call, keep on doing it for some time. You increase the time from 20 minutes to 30 minutes, 40 minutes, 45 minutes. Depending upon the repetitions, how much you do. And it helps you to restore your eye strength, and also for different eye diseases, different medicines are used. Okay. Also, Uttar Basti is used for people with infertility, or for females who are not able to conceive because of the blocked tubes, fallopian tubes, if they are blocked, or if there are fibroids, or if there are cysts. The medicine is introduced into the uterus. By dilating it, it is introduced into the uterus. Also, for male patients, it is introduced to the genitals, which is called as Uttar Basti, depending upon the disease. So now, and ideally they say, chronic sinusitis, the medicine may differ for people who get sneezing at 20-30 sneezes a day, the medicine may differ. But for general healthy people, Anutel Nasya is supposed to be the best. It should be part of Dinacharya, daily in the morning, 2 drops in both the nostrils.
Drug interaction.
Actually, what it is, if you're having, there are two types of Ayurvedic medicines. One is with the metal preparations of the oxides, which we call as bhasma. And one is just crude medicines, which are dried vanaspatis or dried herbs, which we use in the powder form. It could be a combination of 10 herbs, it could be a combination of 30 herbs or 50 herbs. But that is just a powder of dried herb. So now what we can think is, when we have a vegetable soup, that is a fresh soup which we have. But when we are having a kadha, which we boil and take, or when we are having a vanaspati powder, which we take, it is ideally as good as a vegetable which we eat, but it is a medicinal vegetable which we are having. So now, just imagine, when you are having any medicine of modern medicine, you are having your normal food, you are having your vegetables, you are having your chapati, you are having everything. We don't stop taking vegetables. So, it's the same. There is no need to stop taking Ayurvedic medicines, just because you're taking modern medicines, because it is as good as taking some herbs, or as good as taking some vegetables, which are in a diet form. So there is no question of interaction. No question of interaction. In fact, the dose can be later tapered on. The dose of the modern medicine can be later on tapered on, depending upon how effective the herbs which you have taken are. But if you're talking about liver, most of the medicines which are used for strengthening the liver they are Ayurvedic preparations. They are Ayurvedic preparations only. So if you have prescribed Arogya Vardhini, then first thing is, it has to be take it with mixed with the medicines and use it in the form of gametva, then it may help.
But even healthy, I mean, there is a misconception.
Turmeric is good for jaundice. There is no misconception like that. It is good.
And lemon?
Lemon, no.
Lemon.
Anything sour is not going to help. Because jaundice also is of two types. Whether it is obstructive jaundice or simple jaundice, that also has to be understood. Depending upon that, the medicines actually are prescribed. If it is obstructive, then the medicines are different. We start normally first remove the obstruction, get it to normal, and then treat the normal jaundice. That is a avrodh because of kapha. Questions? Any?
We are putting oil is going better.
Yeah, normally they say Nasahi Shirso Dwaram is a sutra. So, whatever medicines which we want to give to the internal system are introduced through nose. Now, when we are taking cow's ghee, the cow's ghee has a quality which is called as Vayasthapan. Vayasthapan is a quality whereby if you take it internally also, the older it is, the more beneficial it is. If you take it internally, it will help you to stop your age to that specific level. It will not help. It will not allow you to age faster. If you are 50 years old and if you are having cow's ghee in a proper proportion, you may look 45 for a longer time rather than looking 50 or 55. You will not age faster. Because of the same quality, you can use it as nasya to keep your senses alive for a longer time in a good quality. And you are asking me about the action of nasya. Your question is, how does nasya work on the system?
The oil will go in there.
The oil, normally see, there are two thoughts, school of thoughts. One, they say, you believe in apta vachan. And one, you believe in scientific things. So what does apta vachan say? Apta vachan means, whatever is written in the text, whatever is written by the Rishi Munis in the standard Ayurvedic text is to be followed without questioning. Why? There is a reasoning for that also. Because if you keep questioning what they have written, then you waste your time in understanding in just accepting those things, then you waste your time in treating the disease. Because most of the research which is going on today is questioning what the science has written. But in the meantime, what we are not following what they have told to do, and what we are not seeing the actual results of what's happening because of that. So instead of questioning that, if we just do it accordingly and study it in that way, that could be our ideal research. But most of the research are done in such a way, why they have told and why it is being done. But if you follow it and do the study accordingly, if you follow them blindly and do it, even then it has a result, effect on your body, that has to be studied. And not questioned. This is one school of thought. Second is, just we follow that nasya because it's apta vachan. Second is, they say, scientifically, when you introduce any medicine through your nostrils, it has a direct connection to the brain and affects your brain.
So, oil is going to intend
that doesn't matter. Whatever openings we have, the oil has to be introduced. If you want to age if you don't want to age faster. Like, if per annus, we introduce the medicine. We introduce basti, medicated oil per annus, to balance the vata in the body. Because apan vayu is the controller of all the other vayus in the body. We introduce oil in the ears so that the vata is also balanced and the aging is slow. Introducing coconut oil or medicated oil in the ears, lukewarm oil. Like we call it karana puran. This is an old traditional, age-old custom which is being followed. Third, we introduce it through the nasya. Fourth, we use it as a kaval and gandush. We take medicated oil. This is the part which is this. They have included in Dinacharya, which I actually didn't include when I told it. They say ki you take 2 spoons of sesame oil or many medicated oil, which is as per the disease, and hold it in your mouth.
For
as long as you can hold it. After some time, you will get strain and you will start getting the secretions from your... You will start getting secretions, saliva secretions directly. It will start increasing, and after some time you will get strain and you will feel like spitting it out. Normally, following such type of gandush, they call it gandush vidhi. It has to be a part of your dinacharya. Ideally,